Well, good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a look at the North American stock markets for Tuesday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures are down. It looks like we're giving up about half of our gains from Monday's big rally. In the commodity worlds, crude oil is lower this morning, while gold is higher in the pre-market on Tuesday morning. Well, if Friday's big decline was caused by comments from a Fed governor, apparently Monday's big rally was also caused by comments from the same Fed governor. And yesterday's big rally gave us an enormous number of bullish reversal signals, and this is the S&P 500. And bullish reversal signals, of course, it's a one-day event that still needs to be confirmed. And for it to be confirmed on Tuesday, we need a higher close. And that would tell us that the bottom is in for this move in the market. Otherwise, if we take out yesterday's low, that would tell us that the bullish reversal signal has been nullified. The signal will be in play until we do take out the yesterday's low, or we do close above yesterday's high. So that signal could be in play for several days or several weeks. But it is a one-day event. And it is no guarantee of a trend change, but it's the first thing that we look for. And unfortunately, on Tuesday morning, we're not trading higher in the pre-market. We're trading lower. And so that tells us that the bullish reversal signal will probably not be confirmed on Tuesday. Now, looking at a couple of 60-minute charts, when the market was rising yesterday afternoon, I was looking to see what would happen, how the market would handle the open gap, and if we would get there or not. On the S&P 500, we did not get there. On Tuesday, an hourly close below 21.4184 is going to be the first indication that we want to go down. The market wants to go back down and retest yesterday's low or break it. But that's the first thing we're going to be looking for is an hourly close below 21.4184. On the NASDAQ 100, which performed better yesterday and got quite close to the bottom of the open gap there, a close below 47.2246 would be the first sign that we're heading back to yesterday's low. And the TSX, which didn't perform very well at all yesterday, we need an hourly close below 14,550.150. To tell us that we're going back down to retest yesterday's low. Now, looking at the VIX, and we're back to daily charts here. I'm watching the VIX closely. I'm long the VIX at the present time. Big bearish reversal day yesterday, just like the market had a bullish reversal day. Close below 1240 would tell us that the VIX is back on a sell signal, and that would be supportive for higher stock prices. So there's the S&P 500. We need a daily close on Tuesday above 21.8039 to give us a new buy signal. Not expecting that to happen on Tuesday. Similar circumstance for the NASDAQ 100. And there's the TSX. Again, we're not expecting new buy signals on Tuesday from what we're seeing in the pre-market. Now, one of the sectors that held up very well yesterday was U.S. bank stocks. They traded through the lower channel line yesterday, but came back and closed in the middle of the channel. There's Bank of America. We're looking for a close on Tuesday below 1563. Closed at 1590 yesterday. So you've got 27 cents to go before you get to a sell signal. Now, Canadian financial services closed lower yesterday, unlike the U.S. banks, and they're being led lower by CIBC at the moment, which is on its second day of a sell signal. Now, we've been watching gold stocks, and I'm currently long the gold stocks. Friday took us down, filled the open gap, and yes, on the right side chart, that was officially a sell signal, but we weren't back to using these charts just yet. So here we are. We're looking for a close on Tuesday below 95.37. That would give us a confirmation, once again, a close below the lower channel line, and that would kick me out. We did fill the open gap that was here. Remember last week we were heading up and we were looking to see how the market would handle this open gap. But we did come back Friday, fill that open gap, so it's no longer in play. And so we're looking for higher prices on Tuesday, and gold is up in the pre-market this morning. For the GLD, a close below 239.49 would give us a new sell signal. And when these index generate sell signals, then you can assume that the majority of stocks in this index are also on sell signals. Looking at the SOX index, we again had a very sharp rally yesterday, did not take out the previous day's high, still on a sell signal here. Similar situation for the transports. Let's finish off this morning's presentation looking at the world of commodities, starting with our agricultural ETF. It's getting pretty close to a buy signal. The close on Tuesday above 2052 would give us a buy signal there. And that would join some of the futures contracts, such as corn, which has been on a buy signal for a couple of days, and wheat, which just generated a buy signal as of Monday's close. Looking at our commodity tracking ETF, which is heavily crude oil weighted, looks a lot like this crude oil ETF. Crude oil is down in the pre-market this morning. A close below 10.43 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. For gasoline, we're looking for a close below 24.03. And we got a pop yesterday in natural gas, and I'm looking to be long natural gas right now, looking for a breakout of the recent highs. We talked about this a couple of days ago. There's our base metal ETF. It's been on a sell signal for a while now, while copper, which has been on a sell signal for a while, actually generated a buy signal on Monday. And so a close below 2362 would kick you out on Tuesday, but that is the first day of the buy signal for copper, and it's certainly been building a base down there at the 2350 level. Looking at the GLD, it traded through the lower channel line yesterday but did not close below it. A close below 126.44 would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. It is up in the pre-market. Now, while gold is trying to hold on to its current buy signal, platinum has been on a sell signal for the last 2 days and trying to hold last week's low. And last up, silver, the SLV closed just above the lower channel line yesterday, so a close below 18.15. would give us a sell signal on Tuesday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Just looking over my shoulder, I see futures have slipped a little more since I started the presentation. The Dow's currently down 145, S&P 500 currently down 17 points. So we're looking to see if we can hold yesterday's low, but I am expecting prices to continue lower from here. Have a great day, folks, and next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning.